tua i session upoi mo ma ma ahia e lomte ngak di kachia hong pailo hi hun khop om hin kathia ikingang non da dia e kon pandia ahun ibi hi oma hi manin ma e thum diole kunni kapawana om namin kon pa toyu nang kon biau hi tuin hiaya central delhi nau pangte to hun e bang tan hiam kazang kho mua tuin e nahoni na nahot damna na tat na thu gen din ka kisawa pa kahon chial na sikha na khain hun loin namung na kam din hon zangin hong pai khom ya na tate na it ma ma te alung tang kongu honon sakin tunia hi ai muna to pa na hepi na na thili theina na hot damna na hong ki se ma na thupi na kamu na ding nang kon chialu hi hai mun na si sanin dai ka kai khum setan ina to pa hun khem som na le setan ina hun dal na te to pa o hun lakhiat saka nangkia min thupi na dinga tunia to pa ko te honon dam dingin na thu hinga hun swak ta sak dingin pa o na khebula kong kilanu hi hun le ko mau na khutan ki kem sakin ka to pa jesu christ minin kong thu mu hi amen Okay. Before we look at the slides, I would like to do a short recap. First, we talked about the truth about the Bible. And there we discussed that the scripture is truly the word of God, that it is inspired, right? Which means everything we find in the Bible is true. Everything we find in the scripture is true, not because our parents tell us that it is true, but because we have lots and lots of evidence. If the devil was able to disprove the scripture, he would have done it a long time ago. But even the devil cannot disprove the scripture. He's been trying. He's been trying to find ways and means to disprove the scripture. But he has failed and he will continue failing. Because it's always historically accurate, scientifically. And we always know. We know that the prophecy in the Bible have been fulfilled. 90% of the prophecies have been fulfilled. So we know the scripture is for real. And that is why we believe what the scripture tells us. And the scripture tells us what? That God is real. And we talked of the truth about God. That God is spirit. That he is omnipotent, omnipresent, and omniscient. So, we worship a God who is all-powerful and all-knowing. We also worship a God who is love, who loves us, right? We also worship a God who is holy. And we talked about how fearful God is. We talked about his wrath, how he always punishes sin, right? And I want you to keep this in mind as we continue. God never forgives sins. God never forgives. Pathianin khelna ngai dam ngelo amo ka ngai dam ngelo. We hear preachers telling us that God forgives our sins. Yes, himale amo ka ngai dam lo. You will find in Hebrews chapter 9 verse 22, it says, without the shedding of blood there is no forgiveness of sins. So for sins to be forgiven, there has to be the shedding of blood. Someone or something has to die. Ihel mana ipiak ditu si na ahi. Scripture tells us the wages of sin is death. Why is it a pathian ka siang tho diktat hinchin khelna ngai damlo. And the only way he forgives sin is through the shedding of blood. Why anachiam teu no? Next, we talked about the devil, the enemy. And I told you, you have to know your enemy. Again, to a sang apil zo, a sang experience zo, a hon khem zo ma amadi. It is only through Jesus that we can defeat the devil. And scripture tells us, resist the devil and he will flee from you. Draw near to God and he will draw near to you. The only way we can defeat the devil is by resisting him, by using the word of God, the scriptures. We talked about the truth about man. The next session we had was the truth about man. And here we learned that man is composed of two things, the spirit and the flesh. We are spiritual beings living in a physical body, right? That's God. That is God's original design. Why patiyan original design hai? Himale bang tiyale. Adamin patiyan tuaman lo ziaka. Patiyan original design pen kisya. It is broken. Kisya intin. He no longer resembles God, but he has resembled the devil, right? Why he tain jin? Why zaka patiyan adi amihing ka huata huat huaita? Patiyan bat pia bol hinapi amiel ma pa hong bang tawive. He created man to fellowship with him. He created man for his glory. Himale amihing bol pen ama adi atil huat huai hong suak bang ziak amiel ma pa hong bang ta. Adam no longer resembles God. He resembles the enemy, the devil. Why zaka patiyanin Adam le Evi Eden huana panhol kya? Huchina Adam in ta ahon niya ataleng ama bang bang ahong piang, spiritually dead, but alive physically. Why apana mihing piang teng teng kibang ta? Spiritually dead, alive only physically. Sadan sawahing khalamasya kipiang mo, and that is what we know as sin nature. That's our nature. And all of you here, even the small ones and the big ones, we are all sinners in the sight of God. And God cannot forgive us without the shedding of blood. Right. Now I have a 2-month-old baby girl at home. She's my daughter. But in the eyes of God, she is a sinner. She hasn't done anything wrong. She has no conscience yet. She does not have a moral compass. She knows nothing but to feed itself. That's all she knows. But in the eyes of God, even that little baby is a sinner. Because we are born with that nature. It's our nature. And the only way God will forgive us is through the shedding of blood. Okay. And I have a question that I want to ask all of you. Do you want to remain sinners or do you want to become children of God? We all want to become children of God, right? Now, two things. First, God hates sin. And because of that, sin must be punished. And the wages of sin, the punishment for sin is death. But on the other hand, God loves you. So two contradicting sentences. God hates sin, but God loves you, right? He wants the sin in you to be punished, but he wants to save you. And remember, there is no forgiveness without the shedding of blood. In the days of the Old Testament, God told his people, the Israelites, that he would accept the blood of animals as sacrifice and atonement for their sins. But those, the blood of animals, the blood of lamb, the blood of goats did not wash away their sins. But they were done, they were sacrificed so that the people would know that they had to pay a price for their sins.
So every time they disobeyed God, every time they sinned, what did they do? They would take an animal, shed the blood, and the high priest would take the blood inside the most holy of holy place, and there he would ask forgiveness using the blood of the lamb. But I want you to remember, the blood of the animals did not wash away your sins, but it covered your sins. God was telling them that they had to pay the price for sins, right? So that is what they did. Now, what did God do? There was a question earlier who said, someone asked me, if God knew that Eve would disobey him and that she would give the fruit of the knowledge of good and evil to Adam, why did God not stop Eve when the serpent was tempting her? Now, that's a good question. Now, God allowed the serpent to continue tempting Eve because God had already given Adam and Eve free will and conscience. In order for us to exercise our free will and conscience, God does not intervene. If He intervenes, we're not exercising our free will, right? But God knew that we, Adam and Eve, could make mistakes, could exercise their free will and be wrong. So He already had a plan to send His Son to tell us about how to live in the kingdom of God. Okay.
Two session pen poi mo injin ihal som do ne chik den chani tak chale chu again kick kick thau dia himale.
And so God always planned to send His Son to save us. And so when Adam and Eve disobeyed God and they were cast away from the Garden of Eden, God did not let them leave naked. He clothed them with animal skin, right? He sacrificed animal to atone for their sins. And that is what Adam and Eve and their sons and daughters have been doing, sacrificing animals as atonement for sins. To remind themselves that there has to be a price. There is a price we need to pay if we disobey God. Okay. Now, we are at a crossroad. We are sinners, but God loves us. And if we try to pay for our sins, we will have to die. The only way we can pay for our sins is by death. And if we die, where will our spirits go? Without Jesus, our spirits remain disconnected with God, and therefore it will go to hell. Okay? And God does not allow that to happen. He loves you.
Aman honin ma maintin. Nasi zo tianga god muna na pai di phallo huai kya hilo leitunga na dam sung ma ma ale ama to na kizop kik di dei ahi pathian in honit ma
huai zia ka a sisan pen topan ki thoina nam tuya san tak salawahi. Our blood is not worthy of the sacrifice because we are sinners. The only blood that can cover our sins is the blood of a righteous man.
Belamle nangaiwo analanal pathianin ma Israel te kyanga akhel namanu piak di chianga belam alag diuleng a utu tu la theilo a belam gen siat be yahi di nat na nei lo wahi di
wai kha siam puina priest in hoi taka belam check in chen. The priest will check the lamb, and then if he finds anything wrong with the lamb, then he will not accept that sacrifice. But if he finds that the lamb is okay, then he will kill the lamb, take the blood, and use that blood as atonement for the sins of the people.
Why he pathiani na dei dana hi ya ya kon gel tho dia ithe siam dina hia pathianom hia mihingom mihingina mihingina pathian deilam ki hi theilo pathian hiailama pana ki zong mu theilo ai aman honle zon ki kele
because we have fallen short of the glory of God. We can search for him, but we will not find him. The only way we can reconnect with God if God searches for us and if he finds us.
Why chiang chawa kha pathian to kimuki thei dimoi why he is soon hon hi sak tunina why he gen khom le hanguti hi
So in this session we will be talking about Jesus. And I'm sorry for some of our friends who I don't know why they're not here. Anyway, this session will be about Jesus.
Anangayo no happy takin hey.
If you doze off or if you sleep, I'm not going to wake you up. Because it messes with the ambience. And it messes with the flow. So it's up to you. It's your choice. I'll do my bit. Okay. So I want to begin from the very beginning. Not from where Jesus was born, but from where Jesus was before the creation. Okay, let's look at this. This is earth, right? Okay. And this is the solar system. And this is the Milky Way. And this is a part of the universe. These are all galaxies, okay? This is a map of the universe. Now, we will divide this plane into two. This lower part is the material universe. This is Earth. It's not to scale, okay? This is the Sun. We have Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune. So this is the solar system. And then we have all the stars and the galaxies. We have all the other heavenly bodies that God created. We have wormholes. Good morning. We have black holes and everything in between. So this is the universe that God created, okay? This is the created universe. Heaven and earth. And this is the spiritual universe. This is the abode of God and all spiritual beings. Now, if there was a rocket that could travel for years and years without having to refuel, and if it were to travel all over the universe, all across the universe, it still would not find heaven. Because heaven is not in this dimension. It's in a different plane. It's a different universe. Okay? Because this is where God lives. This is where God is king. And this is where his creation lives. And there is a great chasm between God's heaven and the physical universe. These are two different dimensions. Okay. Nathi siamu ya. Heaven is real, but It's not just up there. It's a different dimension. And this is where God lives. And here, when we talk about God, we must remember God is the Father, God is the Son, and God is the Holy Spirit. So before the creation of the earth, before the creation of the universe, God always existed. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit always existed before the creation of the universe. And in Colossians, we find Paul telling us that Jesus Christ, God, created the world for himself, by himself. So Jesus was always there from the beginning.
Jesu kichihi Bethlehem apiang hilowinchin. Jesu tangton tangtona omgige. Bethlehem a mihing banga hong piang.
Ahiyo. So, then ahiya yakon lakcheu bangina. Man has been trying to reconnect with God. All throughout history, man has been trying to reconnect with its maker, not just Christians. Every religion is man's search for God. Every religion is man's search for meaning and his search for God. And we have been trying. Buddhism, Jainism, Zoroastrianism, Islam, Transcendental Meditation. Everything is man's search for God. In fact, the closest that man has ever gotten to finding true religion is Hinduism. Hinduism is very close to Christianity.
Himale mihingin pathian muzolo wahi.
And that is why they create their own God, right?
Apathiandu ki boltom mayu. Meaning amulo changwa pathiandi ki boltom
because they want to be justified.
Eya leng why guilty feeling tu nia igen zana igen teng teng omlo la leng.
We know that there is something wrong with us. We know that there is a hole. We know that there is a void that needs to be filled. And when we cannot find the true God, we create our own God.
Why kami ingin ahi dah nahi? Why sih aku na patihanin? Patihan nahi na mihing te na teh na diuna.
So that men will understand who he is. So that men will know who God is. So that men can communicate with him. What did God do? God sent his son.
Atapa mama hon sol. Atapa mama mihing hon suak sakahi. Ama toy kiti teh na ngamo. Patihan kici. Atak tak peni thei na nga atapahon solive pathian le thei di hoi bana khel man le hon piak sak dia hong pa yahi ama
le. So this is what God did. Pa in kha tapa kyanga bangchia. Son, you have to be born as a human being, grow as a human being, live as a human being, and teach mankind how to live a spiritual life while in their physical bodies.
Sadana omlaya khalam hing nailowa khadana hing didan navahil ngayahi.
Why ka objective kat? Objective non to
khadana si spiritually dead ahi manuna akhel manu navapiak sak ngayahi.
Because if their sins are not paid for,
amau kha akhel nawa omden diunchin akhel nawa sidi unchin tangton go na lut diwahi.
Why is it can you have to go and pay for their sins? So Jesus came to fulfill those commands.
Na thei sia mo mo.
Okay, I'll give you an example. So we have a community of monkeys living with us here in this camp, right? So let's just say, this is an example. let's just say our head, the head of our community, calls you up and he tells you, see, I've been looking at these monkeys and they've lost their way. They have forgotten that they are monkeys. They're acting like squirrels. They've begun acting like squirrels and they've forgotten that they are monkeys. And we need to tell them that they are monkeys again. And since we cannot talk to them directly, I want you to turn into a monkey. You will be born inside, you will be conceived by a monkey and you will be born as a monkey. And you will grow as a monkey and you will live with them. And then you will tell them in monkey language how to live like monkeys again because they have lost their path. And after that, you have to die for them. And you have, of course, I will raise you from the dead, but you have to continue living as a monkey when you come back. No way, right? Not even for $1 billion, right? No, I don't think so, because you will be a monkey forever. Now, why would someone say that? Someone would say that only if he loved monkey, if he madly loves monkeys, right? Haizena zongai. Hilele huai chileleng nanghon sole. If he commands you, you have to be born as a monkey. I want to save these monkeys. You have to be born as a monkey and you need to show them the monkey way. Right? Naudwam. Of course you can come back after you have died for them. I will raise you from the dead and you can come back. But when you come back, you will remain a monkey. Naudwam. See. Pathian tapa mihing hong swak chi chianga kha. Ola ol di kisaive. Hileleng, it's easier for you to be born as a monkey than for the Son of God to be born as a human being. Namanumo. Why Zeka, I want you to consider the sacrifice that Jesus made by being born as a human. It's immeasurable love. Immeasurable sacrifice. Ahonit danka. Lom lom mo. I'll give you another example. Say, we're here in Delhi. Hey, Delhi, Amins, and we're a small community. Say, let's just say Lionel Messi hears about us. Okay. Lionel Messi hears about us and he's like, oh, I've heard about this EBCC community and have so much love for them that I want to go and live with them and teach them how to play football. And so he leaves Inter Miami. He leaves his wife and his kids. And he comes and live. And he comes here to live in this hot mess. Right? And he eats what we eat. Breathes the air that we breathe. And he starts teaching us football. How would we feel? You know what our community will be doing? We'll be making a gate around our football field and selling tickets for people to come and watch Messi. Right? And we would be really proud about it. Because for Messi to leave his residence, his club, and to come here and to play for a small community such as us. That's something unimaginable, right? But what if it happened and he was like, oh, I love the EBCC community of Central Delhi so much. I'm going there. I want to live with them. It will be all over the news, right? International news, national news. Even Prime Minister Modi ji would be coming here, right? To have his picture taken with Messi. Now, it's way, way easier for Lionel Messi to come live with us and teach us how to play football than for the Son of God to be born as a human being. I want you to understand the gravity of the sacrifice that Jesus made for us. Jesus is King in heaven. Jesus needs nothing. He is clothed with precious stones. God has made him sit on the throne in heaven. He does not need to come down to prove anything. The only reason why he chose to leave heaven, become a seed, and be placed inside the womb of a woman is because he loves you. And there is no greater love than that, right? Why sanga I na thu pizo a om dia ya? Tu ni na hiai ngai to aleu chinut kahi. Tu takin khwa alum mama imut leng aswak sima himale. Jesu I na ngai to na dia hun hoi takahi nalung simu achiang kuang lai takahi. We know Jesus died for us on the cross. That is also a great sacrifice. But him becoming a human being, him being incarnate as a human being, is the first great sacrifice that he made. Ole. Then chiang ina break chiang in leng tuni taklam chiang in leng hiai hi ngai to leu chin ka uta to pa je sun honi dan. You know, for you to leave your homes, to leave your air conditioned rooms, and to come and stay here for 2-3 days, even that you feel is a great sacrifice, right? No, we lose sleep for a day or two and we're already weak, right? The same with me. But we have to consider what Jesus did for us. He left heaven. And he had no business here on earth. A business omlawahi. He needs nothing. He lacks nothing. The only reason why he came down to earth is because he loves you. Aho needs ya kahi. Why ka theileu chinut kahi? You know, a few months back, you know Rahul Gandhi, right? He came to the Northeast and he came to our town. And people went crazy, right? Especially the housewives, right? Rahul ji, marry me. No, I'm just joking. Anyway, and when they saw him sitting with some of the IDP children, internally displaced children, refugees, people were like, oh, Rahul ji is so down to earth, so humble, sitting with these kids, right? Right. And I'm sure you have heard about Sadio Mane. Sadio Mane is, you can say, is arguably one of the best strikers. Not the best, one of the best strikers of the football. He's got powerful foot. Anyway, he does a lot for his community. He gives back a lot to his community, right? No one can match him in that. King Ai Sangahi. We appreciate and respect his humility. Tuni namo nangai sangdu hon peut kahi nangai sangdu Jesu. Bangziakin kumpiahi vana. Leitunga kumpi leng hilo vana kumpi. Lele van abol sa ahi himale nanga honi zyaka huai pen not siat di kha khiak la tuntuna neilo mihinga hong swadi pen kha thil hak sangai twalawin chin athupi na teng teng koi hia in chin athili theina teng teng sel in chin mihing chi hong swakin chin numei sunga hongomai voi
khakwa paya hongo minchin koimuna hong pianga le. Where was he born? Was he born in the house? Was he born in the palace of kings? Was he born into a wealthy family? He was born into one of the poorest families in all of Judea.
Mizong pen pente in kwan khata hong pianga hi.
Why aziang mo? Ihak sat nating tengu personal taka experience uta hiaman. Kahak sat na pathiani non thei pi ke ichi lo na dia. Hak sat na chikim hong thua kiwe.
So you have your struggles, right?
Hilele huai teng teng pathiani na hon thei pi hi. Okay. Nalom teo happy takina ai imute non phong diwam.
I told you not once but twice not to play. Today's the Lord's day and some of you still played. No, I know some of you played. Don't lie to me. And some of you even got hurt. Now, you're not disobeying me, you're disobeying God. Today is not the day to play. Today is the day to worship God, okay?
Why he na thei khelu kalau mama keinon za tak zia kuyam heu tu te za tak nu le pa te za tak zia khelo.
No, because today is the Lord's day. We devote this day to the Lord.
Na kimol zelu le na khegu khongule tandia hiyo.
I'll pray to God that he breaks your legs if you continue playing on the Lord's day.
A broken leg now is worth it than a broken soul later on, okay?
Now pangten le hoi takin thei siam leo chin kadia hoi jakina ei pauleng sa pauleng hon jangkhom kahio
Jesu va na pana hongkum sukhi hon ngai to leo chinut kahi ahidima isakhak di kalau ahidima hima malo ahi lo di ahi
it should have never happened but it happened because he loves you it happened because he loves you
and so tua kon gente lai siang thowa philippi te bungni changu kapan som le khat ki kala ki muwa hi yo kumpi hin chen himale lai siang thoin bangcha he emptied himself
hong ki suong so this is the first sacrifice and you will also find this in the gospel of john chapter 1 verse 1 it says in the beginning was the word and the word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. And here, the Word stands for Jesus Christ. This is the first sacrifice. God becoming man. Think about this. The whole day today, I want you to think about God becoming man. Jesus becoming man for you. He loves you. You know, human beings, we judge so quickly. We are always so judgmental, right? But God is not. God loves you. And because He knows that we are incapable, He sent His Son to show us the way. And that is why Jesus says, for a reason, he says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. So he accomplished these three things by coming to earth. Okay. So he became the seed of a human being. And he came down to earth inside the womb of a woman of a virgin named Mary. When I think about how Mary would have felt when the angel Gabriel appeared to her and told her that she would bear a child, you know, how would you feel, girls? Ew, right? Ew. Why would I want to bear a child? Bangzia ka naupayun mo di pasalik kinilo. Uthway lo di dan mo. Himale marin bangzia. Pathian sikha kahi, pathian sikha nu kahi. Katunga athu bang bang tunghen chiteleve. That's the type of surrender that God wants all of us to give to Him. Mm. And so what happened? This is what happened. Jesus became a human being. And no, it's not by accident that there was no room for Jesus, for Joseph and Mary when they reached Bethlehem. God wanted His Son to experience the worst birth possible. Okay. Tuatu, we sort of glorified, right? The manger, bongbuk tika, anal tei top dia kibolinjin, bongbuk apiang dibang le litwai kele kilo, mo tu kong atu. Himale, Zesu piang nahi, ganbuk itiang a ek kongom di, a si kongom di, a zun ningim kongom di. Hua alup na nu dangom lo topin, jin mari la va lota, nao ne di hitai tiang a kipuak lampia. Ne hial sanga chia huai mun siang tholo kia ki huai la ka tua bed bugs neng khong le haksa sai nga sachik kichi sahik tampi khongom lai zoma de ve huai la ka mari lumna di josephine boldin chin huai ya kha hong piang hi huchi apianga asial na di munni loma ma hi chianga gan an piang na kuanga asial wa hi in lama na painge hi ya vokan piang na kuang na munge hi ya A siang tho ya? Siang tho lo wa hi. So, our Lord Jesus experienced the worst birth possible. Wai kha ahak satna abula panthuak nga la hi. So that He can understand your sufferings and your hardship as a human being. Amo ka hong pai hilo, Jesus wants to understand your hardships. Ahon pan pi uja kahimo. So this is what is it. All things were made through Him, and without Him was not anything made that was made. In Him was life, and that life was the light of man. The light shines in the darkness, and darkness has not overcome it. John is talking about Jesus Christ. And we have this written in Luke chapter 2, verse 10 to 14. And the angel said to them, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find a baby wrapped in sweating clothes and lying in a manger." Babies are not laid in mangers, but this is a sign that this baby would be laid in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among those with whom He is pleased." So on the night that Christ was born, angels appeared to the shepherds in Bethlehem. And the angel told the shepherd that this day in the city of David, a Savior is born, and He will be known as Christ the Lord. And this is a sign that you will know that He is Christ. He will be wrapped in swaddling clothes, and He will be laid in a manger. And after He said that, a choir of angels appeared in heaven, and they sang a song of praise. And they said, "Glory to God in the highest, and peace on earth among those among whom He is pleased."
Tungnung pe na pathian thupi hen la akipa pi mama mihing telaka lem thu leng hen chi mo apian nia pathianin vana pan alom tu di angelte solahi yahi ichiam te dia.
I'm telling you this because I want you to know Christ is truly the Son of God.
Pathian tapa ahi chi na theidu dei kahi mo
Christ is not just another human being. Le Philippians 2:6-8. Have this mind among yourselves which is yours in Christ Jesus, who, that is Jesus, though he was in the form of God, did not count equality with God a thing to be grasped, but emptied himself by taking the form of a servant, being born in the likeness of men, and being found in human form, he humbled himself by becoming obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. So that is what Jesus fulfilled for us. He became a human being.
Izui theidi mi hong swa keve tua leitunga ivekwa hi naupang hi na piching hile sadana hingdan chuki thei.
We know how to live according to the flesh. No one needs to tell us how to live according to the flesh. We know what we can eat, we know what we cannot eat, right? Rest, we know that we need rest, and we know when to rest and when to work. The problem is we don't know how to live the spiritual life.
Why zia ka jesu ma ma mihing banga hong pain chin spiritual life ai leitunga hindi dan hon hilahi namanumo.
And for that to happen,
okay, let's pray to God. Okay, close your eyes. Close your eyes. Let's pray to God in prayer. Father in heaven, we ask you to be among us. Lord, we're human beings and we have no power. The power is in your hands, and we're not ashamed of the gospel because it is your power for the salvation of those who believe. And we ask that you bring the power into this room. You touch the lives of each of these kids so that they will become faithful disciples and witnesses of your gospel. Lord, we commit ourselves and our time into your mighty hands. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Before we continue, I would like to share a short testimony. I think I was 19 years old when my mom passed away. And when she passed away, I thought that God was unkind and that he had deliberately tried to make my life a living hell. And even my subconscious was against God, and so I decided that I would live my own life and that I cannot leave God. So I went to Mumbai, and there I landed a really good job. A job that paid really well. And so I enjoyed myself, and I stopped praying to God. And because when I was in high school, I was really small. I was a late bloomer. I was really small in high school, and I was always, I was the, what do you call, a nerd. I was really good in studies, and so I had very few friends. I wasn't good in sports. I was good in studies, and so the other guys didn't like me that much. So my aim when I got a good job was to become the popular dude. So I would come here to Delhi to hang out with my friends, and I enjoyed myself without God. That was my life. But that destroyed me. And no, life without God, even if you have money, even if you have friends, it's meaningless. Eventually, you lose your way, and before you know, you're depressed. before you know you're it, you have suicidal tendencies. You're contemplating suicide. Before you know it, life has no meaning. And I think by the time I was 25, I was really lost. Right now, I'm usually between 84 to 87 kilos. Okay. Back then, when I was 25, I was about 48 kilos, less than half. No, a little more than half. I was really thin because I never ate food. I did what I wanted to do, drank what I wanted to drink. So I was really lost. I was depressed, and I completely stopped praying and attending church for almost 2 years. And you know, I thought that if I became the popular guy, if I had money, then I would have friends, then I would enjoy myself. But I couldn't have been more wrong. And I had everything that I wished for, but nothing gave me satisfaction or contentment. And so I came to a point in my life where I thought me being alive was troublesome for my family, and I decided that I did not want to live anymore. And I thought it would be best if I passed on. So I decided to commit suicide. And there was a time when I tried and I failed. And I continued contemplating suicide. I thought, you know, even my parents, my dad and my sisters, I felt that they did not love me anymore. And I felt that I was like a thorn for them, that my existence was painful for them. So I thought if I were to cease to exist, that it would be better for my family and for me as well. So that was what I thought. And I was really in a bad place. I hit rock bottom. It was on the 27th of December 2011. I was lying on my bed. It was Christmas time. I didn't go to church. I was alone in bed. My eyes were open, and I thought, maybe I should pray. And I started sort of crying out to God, and I said, Lord, if you really exist, I don't want this life anymore. I hate this life. I want to end this life. I wish you could have given me a new life. I want to start again. I want a new beginning. I was lying down and I was praying really from the bottom of my heart. And I poured out my thoughts to God. And God answered me that day. He answered me through the scriptures that I had learned as a kid, through the scriptures that my father had taught me as a kid, through the songs that I had learned at Sunday school. And I realized God had always given me the very thing that I had wished for, which is new life and the end of the old one. Alu ipin sile si ulo kerke we ata kapal ulo mo. Kahi siya tamsa lota la kiki mo. Si kisi sumay le kiki mo kilele pa kaya nila. Kalul me unya le kiki tan le tu siri ma kon mundo ma le pa kaya nila kiki kiki tan mai loa. Kahi na alu ipin kon hindi mo sa kiki sin krosan. Kahi na pa kaya nila. And that day I surrendered my life to the Lord, and I accepted Him as my King, my Savior. It's been more than 10 years, and I think that was the only night I prayed for the whole night. I prayed until morning. I was singing songs of praise, thanking God that He had saved me, that He still found me deserving of His grace, right? Kitu kiking dalawa pa tayong niya, and I think some of you may have that feeling too. But tayong niya nong kaya tinong sa tuya, no, He loves you. Kaya ko niya, so I'm not kaya ko niya yung niya nong kaya. I have confessed to God. Kaya ko niya yung niya to pili ko siya pangtina na, pa tayong kita si maitay na yung problema. Malipo tayong niya, puto niya yung way niya. Nangto niya yung niya. And from that day onwards, you know, I did not tell my parents that I was born again. I told no one, but the very next day, I searched for my Bible and I went to church. And I asked the people there when they... about the times, the worship service timings. And I asked my sister, and I went to choir practice. I was the oldest. There was no one older than me anymore. Why niya pantuli tan pasyan na he has not even given me a break yet. One lang to. And it's not, it has never been me. It has always been Jesus. Dunia no le pasyan na inwa on faith yet. Why to say sua? Why? If you believe in Jesus, if you believe that He has ended the old life and He has given you a new life. Why ka aneo din na hindu? You need Jesus because God does not accept the old one. The old one has to be crucified at the cross. He wants you to live a new life through Jesus Christ. A new life that is hidden in Jesus Christ. But he did not accept it, Satan le pang dia even now. There is a battle going on between the forces of good and evil. Naha abya kido na umgi dia ni. Satan in naha al tamdin tebloh ni. Tada na bang, lunglut unlung na bang, mo tilang di unzo pang. Ahi kere, ahi pekhyar tu, cilung si mang lain wang ni. Ah kecil, Michelle le kahilo si mang le kwa kahilo le na fight tu ahi. You need to be saved. Kon tam na hi kahilo le pasyan tahi ti. Him na tham na hi kahilo le pasyan tahi ti. Wah, why se kau ini na tham ni dia hi tam la tu mai tu tu mung ahi yo. Why hi dia kau ahi. Ahi le Yesu tak jen hi genon dia. Yesu hi apian dahi ni mali ihak sama tipi dia orang dia lagi. Ucina tungsung tungsung. Leitu lah ahong kusaa. He lived for 30 years under the radar, which is to say nobody knew what he did for the first 30 years of his life. But what we can gather is that during these 30 years, he experienced every hardship known to man. He learned how it felt to be hungry. He learned how it felt to be sick. He learned how it felt to be rejected. He learned how it felt to be ridiculed. He learned how it feels to be poor, right? Why did he take on such a heavy one? And when he was 30 years old, he began his ministry. And in order to begin his teaching ministry, he went to John the Baptist to be baptized. And listen, as soon as John the Baptist saw him, he said to the people, "Behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world." Behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Remember in the olden days, in the times of the Old Testament, the people of Israel would take a lamb and sacrifice that lamb in order to cover for their sins. Now, Jesus has come and he is the Lamb of God who will be sacrificed for our sins, right? And John the Baptist knew that this was Jesus Christ, and he told his disciples, "Behold the Lamb of God who has taken away, who takes away the sins of the world." And when John the Baptist baptized him, the Holy Spirit came down and acknowledged that this was the Son of God, right? And after that, he began his ministry. Now listen, this is important. Before he began his ministry, he went through the trial of temptation. And we, you know, 90% of the time, we fail. Even Christians, born-again Christians, spiritually mature Christians, we fail 90% of the time. We are far from being perfect. Himale zesuina himale dozo dinahiu tiyon shoda diyata. He went to the wilderness. The Spirit took him to the wilderness, and there he stayed without food and water for 40 days and 40 nights. Mihingin doha kisak pempe tumo gilgiyal naayin. Hunger. And it is because of hunger that people are led to commit crimes. To murder, to rob, to steal, to lie. Zile tate gilgiyal on tiyam atu gumayin. Mole, gilgiyal on tiyam atu mile tak ngamayin. Hunger kahap sa pinpin sa atin for the flesh. That is the hardest thing to be. Why is there God? And I want you to remember this. When Jesus became a man, his power is veiled. At the time, they were a power to have pardon nga omta na omdiwi sa kibulo. Sang lawai Jesus yung power. It's not that he has lost his power. He is as powerful as he was always. He's always been, but his power is veiled. Kisang lawai to para commitment to him. So when he went to the wilderness and he went without food for 40 days and 40 nights, he did that without using his powers. And when he was fighting his hunger, he did that without using his powers. Right? The devil is cunning. He waited for Jesus to be physically weak, right? When you have fasted for 40 days and 40 nights, I think your countenance, that is, your appearance would have drastically changed. Not just one meal, but for one whole day. I'll tell you something. You go one day without food or water, I'll tell you what will happen to you. Without food, you know, we have a really, really short temper. Now Jesus has been fasting for 40 days and 40 nights. Lucifer Satan Muksima Pao. Tunju kahimzo pa ama tadi agil kialo tadi kava paidia kava himbi. Tunju kahimzo tadi chile. Vapayin chin, pamatiale. Then Jesus was led up by the Spirit into the wilderness to be tempted by the devil. And after fasting 40 days and 40 nights, he was hungry. And the tempter came and said to him, "If you are the Son of God, command these stones to become loaves of bread." Turn these stones into bread and eat them. Oh, if you have not, why do not boy boy boy? Nothing my idea, swamp it, and swamp something like that. No. It had me thinking. There's this preacher, Tommy Evans. Yes. No, he said. No, not him. Anyway, there's this preacher who said, Satan, Jesus khian dewa pailaya, yai suang ke tango suak sabia sila na Satan pin tango wana suak sakila ana desugeya. Sire. Mati siya mo yan. You know when Satan went to Jesus to tempt him, and he told him, if you are truly the Son of God, why don't you turn these stones into bread and eat them? Instead of turning the stones into bread, I wish that Jesus had turned the devil into bread and eat him up. Then everything would have been over, right? No, that is not what Jesus is trying to achieve. He's not trying to defeat the devil by doing that. He wants to defeat the devil through us. Each of us must fight our own battles. But what did Jesus say? This will be important for the rest of your lives. This is how you will defeat the devil's temptation. But he answered, it is written, Rema, spoken word of God, the word that comes out of the mouth of God. Man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God. He uses the scripture to fight against the temptations of the devil. And that is why you must learn your memory verses. That is why you must read the scriptures. If you don't learn your memory verses, if you don't read the scriptures, you will never defeat the temptations of the devil. You will not defeat the devil through your power or your mind or your discipline. The only way to defeat the devil is through the word of God. Why is it called memory verse? Kind of my heart is going to memory verse cut late in what so Satan so what told you know. Yeah, let's say sweet memory verse in Yasa. And you know what he's saying? He's telling the devil, you think man is this flesh, but man is not this flesh. Man is a spiritual being, and that spiritual being lives from the word that comes from the mouth of God. The spiritual being does not require food. The spiritual being requires the word of God. If you use the scripture, the devil will flee from you. Amen. Next. Then the devil took him to the holy city and set him on the pinnacle of the temple, that is, on the top of the temple, and said to him, if you are the Son of God, throw yourself down, for it is written, he will command his angels concerning you, and on your hands they will bear you up, lest you strike your foot against a stone. Jesus said to him, again it is written, you shall not put the Lord your God to the test. This time, the devil used the scripture to tempt Jesus. However, Jesus was not moved. He used the scripture to resist the devil. Again, the devil took him to a very high mountain and showed him all the kingdoms of the world and their glory. And he said to him, all these I will give you if you will fall down and worship me. Then Jesus said to him, begone, Satan, for it is written, you shall worship the Lord your God, and him only shall you serve. Then the devil left him, and behold, angels came and were ministering to him. The devil tried to tempt him, but every time Jesus resisted by using the scripture. Now, Jesus did not use his powers. He used the power of the scripture. That is how he will defeat the devil, okay? There will come a time when your friends, or not just your friends, maybe your thoughts will be tempted to do bad things. There will come a time when you may want to try out drugs and alcohol and weed and bad things. There will come a time when you will be alone with your girlfriend or your boyfriend. At that time, you must use the scripture to fight the devil, to resist the devil. Did Jesus physically fight with the devil? No. He fought with him using the scriptures, and that is the spiritual fight. Okay. Why for this one six sakahi lei tuma satam hier na na do so na di wa lai siam thu thu na sat tu pak ya ko na sat wa hin ski hon six sakahi ya hi he pik ta ting siam de le ji ki sia lo di na hi tu wa ki na hi u hier ma ni ni ya tu wa le tu wa me la li pe and the only way you will defeat the devil is if you resist him using scriptures le yaya soina jesu na hi nonzo mi pite sin sakahi he would go from village to village, city to city, preaching the kingdom of God, proclaiming the kingdom of God. What yan gam tu gen mo tu gen in sin sin sakin jet mi pite ya bangaria sin sak. And what is Jesus teaching them? He is teaching them how to live a spiritual life in this physical world. He is teaching them how to live like children of God in this cursed world. Sadana yai khelnai na zo sa sa kupia kha khalam hi kuwa sa bidan le. And for that he walked all over Jerusalem, all over Judea, all over Samaria, teaching the people the kingdom of God. Why asin sana dekha khalam thilahi et sana dia denai gen ba bangale laisya thua se sunachi. The Sermon on the Mount, that is Matthew chapters 5 to 7, in one of the passages there Jesus says, in the olden times it was said, you shall love your neighbor and hate your enemies. But in the kingdom of God, that is now, if you want to live a spiritual life in this physical world, you must love your enemies, pray for those who persecute you. Shingibina namanuwa nidanglaina. In the olden days it was said, an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. But now I tell you, if somebody slaps you on one cheek, show them the other cheek. If somebody takes your cloak, give them your undergarment as well. If somebody asks you to walk 1 mile, walk 2 miles with them. He's teaching not just non-violence, he's teaching resistance to violence. He's teaching Christians the only way to spiritual living is to resist, is to live a non-resistant life. Even if people are being violent, you cannot be violent, is what Jesus is teaching us. It's almost impossible to follow, and it can only be done through the filling of the Holy Spirit. Anyway, he spent 3 years teaching us how to live. Kung tum hot se gebe le tuma hi kwa sa tida. And you can find this in the Gospels. Why be nasim do hi kanao gebo? Nasim ki ule Jesu the biro di na hi. And if you don't know him, you will never love him. And if you don't love him, you will not follow him. You follow people that you know and love. Tuale na et tam tamu nasim tam tam te om da na om na hi. You may say no, but your character and the way you dress and the way you speak says otherwise. Korean movie ko ai ke le ke po ko ne ta ko le wai ta ma om ai. Ai ke le heavy metal ko mai ne ko le wai ke ta ma om ai. Mo hip hop mai sa na ye wai ke ta ma om ai. Why is it that Jesus nung zui de na chi ke tu? You need to know him. And in order to know him, you must read the Gospels. Why na sim tam che wa ma hon thi sim sim de na yu. Na thi sim sim che wa hin sim sim. Why is it that nung zui ke ba? Na thi sim wa. Ke ba ngin le ai mai sa ka ne sim ti ba. Mi movie star ko, ai ke le band ko, ai ke le footballer ko, ai ke le sports person bi. Why is it about to say to na hong dong leu to Hollywood to say bang le dong sang an he so ni ka hi. Why he le em to a chu ta bi ni tai ba ke man lo lo ma ke le why ka thi sia ka intentionally you have to devote time to Jesus, to learn more about Jesus. Now, who did you get? No, not you. So, you know, they say, what? Len, it's your sin sucking, a sin sucking, and a sin suck so a car. I told now the ultimate sacrifice of the anyway to death on the cross, right? Why he gets what I left all the time? Even a ton time, then in a sort of maxima. Yeah, in a empty ammo, it is a side of it. Yeah, Passion of the Christ. Movie apa nih ya? Yesus mata aom sana kipana cross asi nanti aku nggak tahu ya. Sinsakit tengah sinsak soina Yesus mengatakan, kami tapa ka mataundi how the Antonia Tono Nikahit, he can sell out. No drinking him with her. The Sunama Mandi was his birthday, that he was his name. Why he saw Vanapara Hunkumami on Swagahi? Himale Mata on the Nizarina Haksa Asamapa and Zuite Kanamo. It whom knew Kalmahakma. I am filled with sorrow to the point of death. Setanina doimapan mirmapan honzo khadim ithundi wachia getsemani wana alutwa athumwa athum nawase sun apakena genmo pa yai kathil tuani liploma ma kai ai thile honbe asak khat bekya mi no in sim ni ve thum ve nge thum ve ge tuma le pathya rin do mo yi haksa sa loin chit a khon kha si sa pa lo yes e ki pa lo e kon ge ni o se ta kha ta la ta ya se chu se su kro sa si se ka ama bo a le ta is defeated because Jesus died on the cross. Okay. The worst of sinners are crucified on the cross. Romans have different ways of execution, and the cross is the worst among them. They have honorable deaths. They have honorable ways of executing people. The cross is not one of them. The cross is the worst way to die. The cross is where they execute murderers, rapists, thieves. Zesun Khelmani Wahi. Cross aung si bangzeka lina. Athwa gipti sama alizotu, more than the physical suffering, it is the thing that will be laid upon him that he is filled with sorrow for. And what is that? The sin that you have, the sin that is inside each of you. Na hoy lo na thinking mo pat yare na ama tu ma koi ni dai. Kei ko ki ge mo. Kei hoy lo na thinking Jesus. Why Jesus apua ni pen ama lin na ni nai ki pa ta ka apua a ki pa hian ta pa hak salo chi san san lo hak sa salo de lin loin chin apa kya ra hon pel sa mai pe cha mi en bun bun not once not twice but three times. Why a apa ko cha do ma chi ni ko Jesus lu gim lo lin loin chin kha kha me ya pu ke be he fainted. And God sent an angel to give him, to encourage him. One soul, one soul, one soul, one soul. Why are you going to say, not to know the Lord, but you can't hear the Lord. It's a commitment to say, you can't hear the Lord. Ahile, ahon manwa, hon gotwa, hon zekwa, ole. Then anawin ahon dotka, that's very important. Was the devil happy when they quit Jesus, when they beat Jesus, was the devil happy? Was the devil happy when they crucified him on the cross? I'll tell you, no, he was not happy. Because we see, you saw the man Jesus being beaten, being brutally beaten, right? Nasa taka Jesus bua ka om bu chi wa ma le pat ya ni mo nang e le wa ya bua ka bole Jesus at wa ku hin je hi ma le pat ya ni je su yi lo hin je po wa ya bua se su ta mi hi mi hi al de na ma nu mo wa ya ka wa ya Jesus no ni tu hel na ma hu ya le he is paying the price of sin. The Roman soldiers think that they are beating up this Jewish man called Jesus, but no. In reality, Jesus is using the Roman soldiers to take his price. Aman, Shetaman, Anget, and Ladia, Roman soldiers, this Amani. And they are beating Jesus in his stead. But Yanta, Roman soldiers, then say Susie. Zesupin, Eta, Aman, more. So every time, every slash, every cut, every wound, those are used to pay the price for our sins. Asisan luang ting ting, atike ting ting, aliang ting ting ha, ishal naman biyak aliang isahe. Why is it that setanin mo, Zesu kize kong mo, Zesu sisan luang mo, wajaka macho chiri, hello, tell me, wang ziakin. Shall naman patyanin lahim tayo sa ka. Huwag gita ting tingka shall naman na piyak kung ayon lo. Mihiyala asyo ngayon lo. Asyo lele, tanto ni natuho niya sidwa ni mana. Satan mo alila ni naman mo. Through the blood of Jesus Christ, the devil is defeated. Ahile sa Yesu ko yung sinasaya po. Yay ite isek ka niya. Lai siyang towa. Isai mong so ma le tuma akigat dia Zesu ahong pian ma kung sasagi na isai Zesu ahong tuwa meritu gen for pahi. Why so tiyang ina tanjin ko itiya akimwa? Why so tiyang ina Zuda historian dena Jewish historians have records of the day Jesus died. Why tiya pa nalay kimo? Prophets tiyang keluwa pa nalay kimo. Kita dah nampak kau tahu sih semua waktu kau naked. He was laid bare naked, and he was whipped. He was whipped 39 times. So tumle kau bayi siapa? Imale aku siapa tapan zatkar? Whipped down in jin amoma. At the tip of that, there are 12 leather strings that come out of the whip. And on each string is a sharp object. And every time Jesus is whipped, 12 wounds appear on his body. Munso leniya ama unchak. Ahunto asato ichakai. So 39 times 12 is how much? More than 400 wounds. More than 400 flesh wounds on his body. 416. Actually, it's a pumping thing gets in a year. Sis at one says, why can't you say, why can't? But he had in a tapase, but he had in Michiel, they say, that is the price that is being paid for our sins. Why is it that says, suit one man, it's young one, why at one because I want you to remember this. It was supposed to be me, it was supposed to be you. But Jesus took our place and he paid the price for our sins. Why is that eight days we hear our issue? I don't know. But he had punishment here, I don't know. Say soon again, Amen.
Amen.
I'm on a price for him. Why is that say sweet? Why? And that is why we love Jesus. I'll tell you, we'll get this one later. Okay? Yeah, it's one. This is what Christ did for you. This is you. You're dirty. You're a sinner. This is Christ. He has no sin. You're a sinner. Jesus is holy. This is what Christ has done for you. He has made you clean through his blood. Aman na helman ting ting apiak siya kapatihan mitua. Nang asya mong suwasa. Bang chitanin. Natin na na helman ting ting ka. Ama kila atibe. The scripture says, he has become a curse for us. He has become sin for us. Kis wangen, the lies that I have told, right? The sins that I have committed. There may be sins you have committed that you never want to talk about again. Shalanahi utnagirun non het lole om din abang siyak, nasun luan siyak wak, zala koy na sakwa tu kem nalih ikat adil. Why ting ting lemo? Jesus ama kinakahi. He owns it. He takes it for himself, and so in God's eyes, he has become the sinner, and in God's eyes, you have become holy. Why shall nothing think aman chip wa in chen? Aman lehon biya. He paid the price. For our sake, God made him, that is Jesus, to be sin, who knew no sin, so that in Jesus we might become the righteousness of God. Beautiful, right? Because Jesus has taken all of our sin, we have become righteous in the sight of God. And we praise the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
But God shows his love for us in that, while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Jesus ahong siya ha, na hoy du, na kel no lo du, why jam so in ton hong nam di siya? No. Hoy so lo di, si hong hei jin, I hoy lo lai la ya, ea de hong siya hoy du. Why ki hong kim tam la ki hong sui leo jin hiya lo lo, ina yu ti mo, ama muan hoy ya ni, ama lo mo. No to wa so lo di na hiu, ei to wa so lo di hi jia ki jia ka aman, mi hiya lai lai ka, ton tang hiya jin. That is how much he loves us. When you go back, don't break up again. I want you all to read Isaiah chapter 53, verses 4 to 9. Isaiah 53, verses 4 to 9. Yet God is talking about Jesus. Surely he has borne our griefs and carried our sorrows. Yet we esteemed him stricken, smitten by God and afflicted. But he was pierced for our transgressions, he was crushed for our iniquities. Upon him was the chastisement that brought us peace. Upon him was the punishment that brought us peace. And with his wounds we are healed. And we like sheep, all we like sheep have gone astray. We have turned everyone to his own way. And the Lord has laid on him the iniquity, that is the transgressions of us all. He was oppressed, he was afflicted, yet he opened not his mouth. Like a lamb that is led to the slaughter, like a sheep that before its shearers is silent, so he opened not his mouth. By oppression and judgment he was taken away, and as for his generation, who considered that he was cut off out of the land of the living, stricken for the transgression of my people, and they made his grave with the wicked and with the rich man in his death, although he had done no violence and there was no deceit in his mouth. Isaiah prophesied that Jesus would die for us. Isaiah told us that Jesus would pay the price for us. Now, I want you to watch this knowing that it should have been me, it should have been you, and not Jesus Christ. A price is I keep wondering, if now I don't feel I'm deserving of his love. And I think it's only fair that I give my life to him, that I surrender my life to him. And I want you to do the same. Not accept him, surrender yourself to him. Kipun piyak ni, awu tu tahong sat piya, anung zui dia kipun piyak. Iki surrender deni. convenient ama ini mo boss deni in leader deni ai ama why they no tento pamina muchas kahi. So the God says, for the wages of sin is death, right? And Jesus paid the price for our sins. He paid the wages of sin. And as I said, behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. And that is what Jesus did. And the Lord has laid on him all of our sins. Right? Continue. Ibiyan kan khel na why idiyan gin pin le si sun kwa if you hoy lo hi teng teng le si sun kwa inai kwa na hoy lo teng teng le si sun kwa ilung dun hoy lo teng teng le si sun kwa isin ama cross up on si le why se kan na na hoy si akilo hoy lo bp Zesu cross us is a car for Kadin Nam Hoy Ahun Bumani. Nahoy Nilo Lila Zesu cross out is a Zeka and more for Kadin Hoy Ahun Bumi. I was Zesu competing in Sangam. Zesu is with you. Commitment number one for him. Mimamala. Let's all check in a break of India. Na break sumo na na room one na luti bi wa kwa ma inkoma kung mo ma le e room ting hoi lo bi ane yung tayo kung mule na bilo hiye bi ho na room one na umdi wa ton distracted til le na koi hiye wa I want you to pray tundi I want you to pray and I want you to ask Jesus to be your king. And I want you to surrender yourself to him. Confession na mo luto male, make confessions. Sins na hiyal na hon dong hon suka mo, why ka yung nagising mo na siyo mo, gen kya wa o sesu niya. To pa why ka yung ka, cross up na kiplun na mo, kapong to pa kung ngay na rin. Confession mo di mo, it will free you if you do that in Jesus' name. Lekha ben lai di, sesu mga nisa, this is the old you, that is the sinner, the old nature. Adam swan bin ngay mo. Zesu hen sumangi bin. Adam swan om nol lo hobe la agi uta dia dia. Bak zia kin. Korin ton ni unga chak so besa dia mong ye na. Okay, kone mo ya. If anyone belongs to Christ, then he is a new creation. The old things have gone, everything is made new. So, the fact that you are a descendant of Adam is gone, erased. Adam swan, shall na ipai penze sun prosakimu, na huayum no lohi, na natak swakta. Pang swakta itile, you have become a child of the promise through faith. Abraham swan swakta. Galatians 3:29. Can God sing beyond? You belong to Christ, so you are Abraham's descendants. You get all of God's blessings because of the promise that God made to Abraham. Now in Christ, there is no difference between Jews and Greeks. There is no difference between slaves and free men. There is no difference between male and female. You are all the same in Christ. And you have become a descendant of Abraham, children of the promise. Israel take care in all of Jesus yaka Abraham swan ginna pate tuchiam tate swan tate biwa pathiato Jesus to go ma khong de And that is what God has given you through Jesus Christ. And in Romans 4:25, it is written, Jesus, who was delivered up for our trespasses and raised for our justification. For Christ also suffered once for sins, the righteous for the unrighteous, that he might bring us to God, being put to death in the flesh and made alive in the spirit. Jesus suffered for our sins once for all, so that he will put to death unrighteousness. Now, finally, koi chidana se sun, idi munokhi sakai chile. This is you, this is me, full of sin. But Jesu asiyang koka, ama suma ehon sile yaman, naman mo. He hides us inside him. What he had in April of it, Jesu muta, why is there God? What he had in Waika, meeting the righteous people. Not because we have done righteous deeds, but because we believe in the righteous one. Olha, Romans 10:9, I memorized Romans 10, yeah? Romans chapter 10, verse 9. It's a famous verse. I memorized them, yeah? If you will confess with your mouth that Jesus Christ is Lord, and if you will believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, then you shall be saved. Again, Jesu nang yasyehi, si nakik naging taka, ama kumpia na sama, atonon si naging taka, ipotam na hindi si mo. Tono na, itatya na biyeng siya kiki. Tawa na tuwigin, itat siya tapolong so sa kiki. So this is what I want you to do. Simpi yung niya lang. Simpi na doon niwa. Simpi doon so siya. Find the find an open space, maybe your room or maybe outside. I want you to pray. It has to be personal. I cannot give it to you. Why did Jesus give that surrender? And what has God, what has Christ done for you? Jesus more. He ay napulpi ko ilo pa cross at yung mga hindi. Of course, you're still here. Na ko ilo nga nang lung si pero la himani pa kaya hindi ay pika ako yung mga punta. Jesus ay ka. Kini na wahi mo si mga ikomin na tumdiwa. No, mi mga mala na kilatulong na isa. Kaya ito pa pa ay kundi kapapa na om kapunsatu na kipula hapon lang ang taong nitsa. Nang tilipin ay ang tupa ang ay hindi nung tanga namang sema, din siya nga nang maya hong ko na hong tung siya patupa. Hang san taga, piyang tag si topa huwag kitiya. Katopa si su kung piya sanga hong nampa kita niya topa, anong suy at hong na laki na limon. Tuni niya yung tingin topa, nakapi na, navenbing na, kung yan sa kahi. Sa tanin hiyem soma, tada na, lakto na, anong tango at siya tuling panang dalin hodang na tangak to pao abiyatang na nigun ang mabiring kong tumi at humahin na tuwi sa sakin at tumpas Jesus Christ ng kong tumi.
Amen.
Ang bulwari,